Leo, and welcome back for another tarot reading. Today is another general reading, Leo, so it may or may not resonate with you. So just take the part that fits, discard the rest, because it only means that this is not the reading for you at this time. Also, keep in mind, Leo, the energy can be interchangeable. So when I say you, it could be your person. When I say your person, Leo, it can be you. So just keep that in mind as you hear your spread. Now, I'm pulling from the Psychic for the Heart Oracle deck here to pull the emotional aspect of your person's energy pertaining to how they feel about you, Leo. Now, Leo, this is how your person feels about you. They're coming up in the number one base chakra. They feel like you need your base chakra fixed or aligned because they feel like you're caught up in the things of the world. And the base chakra deals with your security, your earthly things, feeling secure, being able to provide for yourself, just the things in life, period. So they feel like this is a thing that's crowning you here, the thing that's playing the biggest part against you or against this relationship is that you're putting the materialistic things against emotional things here, pertaining to your connection with your person here. So underneath this one, you got two ones. Number one, base chakra. Then you have the number one, clarity of belief. They feel like you need to introspect here. You need to tap into a spiritual place here so that you can transform your thinking here because you're stuck on the worldly things. No emotions, just self-satisfaction or self-gratifications here. It's all about what Leo wants here. Now, this is how your person, look, don't stone the messenger. I'm just relaying the energy as I see. So your person feels like you need some type of clarity, some type of spiritual intervention so that it can transform your thinking here because your thinking is off. Your thinking is all about self and what you can get out of relationships, even the world here. So your next card, your person feels like you need to step outside of yourself. Like I said, step outside of yourself and look at yourself here. Look at it from all different angles. Look at it from your person's perspective of how you may have handled this situation and handled this connection here in this number 12. Your person feel like if you do all those things, then you can have success and there could have been growth within this relationship here. And they feel like if you could do this, go outside yourself, introspect, transform your thinking, your theology, then it would allow your energy and your heart chakra to open. Your emotions will flow freely here. You'll show more emotions here and not just be all about yourself here. So they feel like you also have a communication problem here where you need to speak up. You need to tell your truths here and you're not doing that here. So your person's first card coming up, Leo, is the Two of Swords here, which is air energy, Libra, Gemini, and Aquarius energy here. Now, this is your person looking at you like you just didn't make a decision. You just ain't going to make no decision because this person is not in a... Well, this person is in a mental prison, but they're not physically bound by any means. They could easily get their ass up and walk on and do what they need to do. But this is your person feeling like you, Leo, just didn't make a decision where they were concerned about this connection. So underneath the Two of Swords, we have Justice, which is Libra's card. They said like you didn't make a decision because you just didn't care. And as you not making a decision towards this relationship, there it was not fair. It was not a reciprocated connection. There was not an equal give and take. The scales was not balanced in this connection. It was something off here. And so next to your Two of Wands, we got your energy, Leo, Sagittarius, and Aries in this Knight of Wands energy here. So this is how they're feeling like you didn't want to settle down. You put the earthly things above or before this connection. Therefore, you left this person out and you mishandled them. You did not treat them fairly because you was operating in self-gratification here in this Knight of Wands where you're passionate. You're coming in, but you're not planting any roots here. You're just in it for temporary gain just to get what you want out of this relationship, Leo, while you didn't care about your person here. So underneath this Knight of Wands, we have the Eight of Pentacles here, which is earth energy, Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn energy here. Now, I feel like this is your person here. This is you coming in and out to your person like this. Your person was good on their own in this Nine of Pentacles, but they wanted a relationship. They didn't want a playboy. Yeah, just because they were single didn't mean that they wanted to remain single. They were single to add to what you had or to add to you, but they feel like you just took advantage of them being independent, beautiful, single, and just came in and got what you wanted to get, and then you was right on back out the door again here. Therefore, they feel like you need to balance that out here. And so now you have the Eight of Pentacles next to your Knight of Wands here, which is more earth energy. This is Taurus, Virgo, and Capricorn. Now, realistically, your person noted that it wasn't a fair, equal, give and take balance connection here, but your person actually wants you to work on this connection. Your person wants you guys to come together and work on this connection because your person does have feelings for you still. Your person is happy when they think about you in this Sun energy, Leo. See, this is your card right here. You got the Sun card right next to the Nine of Pentacles here. So you made this person happy when you were at your best, but I feel like in the beginning, you probably made this person happy, but I feel like, you know, just like the Knight of Wands, you're in and you're out, so it became a problem here. You needed to make a decision if you wanted to plan rules or if you just wanted to just have fun. But I feel like your person, although they were single and doing good, they wanted more. They didn't just want to just fuck, you know. They didn't want just a fuck buddy. They wanted someone they could build stability with because they wasn't coming in here empty-handed here. So regardless of this person talking about all these things where they have a problem against you, I still feel like your person still had a lot of love for you and you still made this person smile in the Sun energy here. So I feel like this person feel like the only way it can work is you're going to have to do some type of healing. But I feel like your person has already made their judgment pertaining to this connection. And they feel like it's just too much work to deal with you because they feel like it was just too much confusion and fussing and fighting with you because you wanted to do your thing while your person wanted to do their own thing here. And so they feel like it's going to be too much competition. So I feel like your person's making their own judgment call and ending this once and for all. Because they feel like you're not going to take this connection serious. You're just immature. You just want to explore. You just want to have a good time, but you're not planning any roots here. So I feel like if your person feels like if you come back to them, Leo, even though your person's made a judgment call not to accept you back already, then you're going to be greeted by this Knight of Swords from your person. See this Page of Wands and this Knight of Swords confronting each other? This Page of Wands don't stand a chance. I'm just saying, this Knight of Swords is your person about to go ham on your ass if you come any kind of way here, because they've already passed their judgment. They already feel like they know what you're up to. You're not going to invest in them. You're just going to be in and out just to have sex, and then you're going to be on right on to the next one. So your person made their judgment call to let it end, but this cycle has come to an end, though. Yeah, this cycle has come to an end. But it's kind of sad because it's like this cycle has come to an end for your person. And I feel like this is your person, the Queen of Cups, and you, which is the King of Cups. So I feel like the cycle has ended for your person. That was this your person was a water sign. Your person was pouring emotions into your cup, Leo. But I feel like here you are, Leo. Yeah, you may have had some feelings for them, but you did not show it. So that cycle is over. Your person is no longer going to pour into your cup because I feel like they don't care that you love them now, because after this King of Cups, we have the Devil energy, which is Capricorn energy. They feel like they're not going to try to get this connection back, nor do they want it, because you're toxic, you're selfish, you're all about your needs and not theirs, and they don't want to deal with that. And not only that, after this Devil card, you got the Five of Swords. Your person don't want to deal with this ego tripping and this mind game. This is how you did them before in this Knight of Wands energy here. So they don't want it. They feel like you're just going to set them up and you're trying to bound them again in your game that you're going to play. You're going to try to trap them again in your games that you play, because ultimately you're going to be trying to get them in, but you're going to be out giving to somewhere else like you've always been doing in this Knight of Wands energy here. Giving somewhere else, being the life of the party, having fun somewhere else. It's like your person's looking at you like, no, I don't want to be with you. You're toxic. You're just going to play games, because all you're going to do is give somewhere else. You're going to go out there and trick with them girls again like you always do while you leave me, your soulmate, neglected here. Because this is your soulmate, Leo. It could be a Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. But your person feel like all you're going to do is trap them in. You're going to lure them. You're going to play the mind games. You're going to use that Leo charm that you always use to manipulate them here, to get them right back in. And then all you're going to do is go back doing the same old thing you was doing. Not an equal, give a fair give and take, because you're only after yourself. And you're going to ultimately go out and give to other folks. You're going to entertain other people while you forget all about your soulmate here. So your person says your soulmate's Leo. So Leo, my darling Leos, this has been your reading for How Does Your Person Feel About You, Leo? So if this video resonates with you, Leo, please like, share, subscribe, leave me a comment, hit the notification bell, Leo. Happy, happy new year to you, Leo. And I'll talk to you on the next video. Bye.